Hey everyone, I'm Ed from BobJohnson.com, and you're watching part one of our two-part series on how to bring new life to your old Toughbook using Linux. We have here a CF-29 Mark IV. It's about 10 years old, but it's still in really nice shape. It came with XP originally, which, as you may know, is no longer supported, so you should not use it if you're going to be connecting to any kind of network. We could install Windows 7 on this, but it's not really built to run it. It's kind of slow. So instead, what we're going to do is give this thing a new lease on life with some Linux. If you're brand new to the world of Linux, don't worry, it's not as intimidating as you might think. And I'm going to walk you through every step. To follow this tutorial exactly, you'll need a computer with an internet connection and a DVD-ROM burner. You'll need a blank DVD with at least 2 gigabytes of space. And you'll need your Toughbook with a DVD-ROM drive of its own, and at least like 5 or 6 gigabytes to be on the safe side in the hard drive. Okay, so one of the first things to know about Linux is that it comes in a lot of different flavors or distributions, distros, they sometimes call them. We're gonna go with a distro called Elementary OS because it is pretty user-friendly, nice to look at, and lightweight. If you'd prefer to try out something like Ubuntu or Linux Mint or something like that, you can go ahead. This is built on the same platform as those, so the installation process will be more or less the same. So just navigate in your web browser to elementary.io. You get this page. It'll ask you to give some money. We're going to put in a value of $0 just to start out. If we like it, we can come back later and give some more. But we'll just put in zero for now. And then you just click the blue button. We want 32-bit because our CF-29 that we're working on does not support 64-bit. So you just click that to download. It's over a gigabyte, so it can take, you know, an hour or more, depending on your connection speed. But we've already downloaded this in advance, so I can go ahead and cancel that. Then your computer, just go to your download file, find the Elementary OS ISO, disk image file. And make sure your DVD-R is in your drive, by the way. That wouldn't hurt. And right-click. Click Burn Disk Image. It'll open up the Windows Disk Image Burner. You can select Verify Disk After Burning if you want. And then you just burn. Grab the disk you just burned, and before you start up your CF-29, just pop open the drive, pop the disk in, and power up. When we get to the Panasonic logo, we want to hit F2 to enter the BIOS. And we're doing this just so we can tab over to the boot options and make sure that it's set up to boot from the DVD/CDRW is the number one priority. And we can see that it is. So we'll just hit F10 to save and exit. Now, it'll pop up a little thing saying some probe failed. That's just a really common bug. It won't affect anything, and the information is, there's nothing to do with that information, so you can just ignore that safely. All right, so this will just load for a while. All right, here we go. All right, so once it boots up, it's going to give us the option to either just try it from the disk or to install it. We're going to go ahead and install it. And you want to connect to the internet when you're doing this because there's going to be a bunch of other junk it's got to download. So I'll put in my super secret password here. And we'll hit connect. And it'll connect. Doop, 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 doop. Okay. Let me just type it in again, make sure I got it right. All right, looking good. Click continue. And we can see that we've got all of the requirements. We meet all the requirements to install this successfully. So just let's go ahead and download all these updates while installing. That'll keep us kosher. You kind of need a lot of this stuff just to function normally. This disk is already blank, but you know, we're still choosing erase disk and install elementary. So it's selected, let me just install now. At this point, you would be able to set up a partition with Windows if you wanted to. We don't have Windows on this hard drive, so it's not an option for us. We're just going to do a fresh, clean install. It'll ask where we are. That's just so the clock will function correctly. New York's close enough. Continue. Keyboard layout. We can test it if we want. Oops. Hard angle to type from here. Yeah, okay. Now it's asking who we are. I'm Ed. I went ahead and created a name for the computer and a username. For whatever reason, usernames are not allowed to start with a capital letter, so I'm just Ed, all lowercase. I'll choose a password. I'll choose my standard series of asterisks. Log in automatically. And now it's just copying files from the disk. This part can take a little while, so I'm just gonna fast forward. Okay, installation is complete. We need you to restart the computer in order to use the new installation. Restart now. All right, so it's gonna ask us to remove the media. So we're gonna take the CD out and close up the drive and continue from here. Just hit enter. this first time you're booting up, it's gonna take a lot longer than it will in the future. All right. So now we've got it all started up. There are still a few things that we're gonna need to work through. The mouse is excruciatingly slow. We get this system problem here. We've also got this issue here with the touch, where the calibration is kinda out of whack. And for most cases, it might not happen to you, but usually with the CF-29, we also have this problem where when we go to restart it, it will start to restart and then it'll just kind of get locked up and you have to hold the power button and shut it off completely and turn it back on. We'll be fixing all of those issues in part two of this series, so stay tuned, check it out. Thanks for watching. For more Toughbook related videos, subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to use the coupon code YouTube next time you're on BobJohnson.com for 5% off your next purchase.